Hurricane Florence bearing down on the Carolina coast. And one of our very own was down there vacationing and I believe is amidst of an evacuation right now. From the world famous Kirk and Marianne show, we have our very own Marianne. Good morning, Marianne.
Good morning.
Hey.
Hey, I've been following you on social media. It looks like you had a beautiful vacation planned with the fam. And then this twirling, whirling death cyclone off the East Coast just basically puts you right in the crosshairs. And were you a part of a mandatory evacuation?
Yeah, I got the call yesterday. We were going to go to the sand dunes. You know, those, I don't know if anybody knows Kitty Hawk and like Fly Kite. Going to have a great day. And we got the call 7 a.m. tomorrow. You got to be out. Mandatory evacuation. Apparently they stagger. So the tourists have to go first. That's us.
Right.
And then the owners, they're really encouraging them to leave next. But everywhere we go, the locals are like, well, so everybody has their own theory. A lot of locals are like, this is nothing. It's not going to happen, you know. And then the guy that boarded up our rental house yesterday, he was like a salty old pirate that's seen everything.
Hell,
and he's like, I've never seen a hurricane like this. This is going to be the big one.
Oh, no. Listen to that guy.
Yeah, he's on my Instagram, actually. I took a sneaky video of him because he was so cute.
Oh, hell yeah.
But he was like, this house won't be standing after this week.
I've been on these shores for 70 years, and I ain't never seen nothing the likes of this.
Nothing.
I had three wives washed out to sea from a hurricane half this size.
Did the family... Right. Now, this is a big family trip you're on. Your great husband, your daughter, looked like there was some other folks there.
Ma Dukes
was there.
Are you all in the car right now together evacuating?
Yeah.
Okay, so, yeah, it's my mom, and it's basically she says her last hurrah. She's 82, and she's like, I can't fly anymore, so this is it. This is our big last vacation. And then, you know, my husband and two-year-old, and she footed the bill, so it was the most expensive 3 days ever. And, we all thought, but like you said, we've had gorgeous 3 days. It could have been rainy and gross, so...
So where are you now? You're all in the car. Are you in?
We're jammed in here, and we didn't really expect to take mom to Baltimore. So her giant suitcase, like Robbie is crammed in the back middle seat.
Who's driving?
I'm driving.
Shout out, Marianne.
Turn up, man. The matriarch of the family.
Getting it done.
Hell yeah.
I do the driving.
Yeah, I like that.
You know what's funny? How you guys love that car that Robbie built in the basement, and he does his driving and all that.
And he doesn't even drive.
He doesn't even drive. Now, when it comes to real world driving, I'm number one in the world at getting my family home safely.
Strictly video game driving for Robbie. Now, so is it? What are the roads like? Are they slammed?
He hates driving.
Are the roads
not like actual driving?
Are the roads full of traffic? Are you sitting in traffic, bumper to bumper? Are you moving, or what's going on?
Well, since it was 7 a.m. for everybody, we thought it would be bad, but we're fine. We only have a 15-minute delay, according to the app.
What's your ETA to arrive back in Maryland?
12:30.
Not bad.
And 12:30, and I mean, it is a gorgeous day. It killed us to leave. It's just been so beautiful.
Now,
but everybody said, you know, we talked to a little local girl at this ice cream shop, and she was like, oh, this isn't even going to be a Cat 5. It's going to be a Cat 3. And, she had all these theories
about it's
going to be nothing.
Yeah, yeah. This is old hat to them. They've been slammed into so many times by hurricanes that turned into tropical storms. And I'm speaking from experience here, okay? I've been around this block here at WIYY for a little bit longer, and I'm telling you right now, do not acquiesce when Rick calls and says, well, you're in town, you should maybe come in. You're on vacation still. You stay your ass with the fam and you have a staycation.
I already got the text,
by the way.
Damn! I knew
it! Damn!
Rick.
Come on, Rick!
Cold-hearted Strauss, like a cobra. Well, you're in town.
And just so you know, Friday night, we left in the middle of the night to leave, and he knew we were leaving in the night, and I stayed in that van at the Maryland State Fairgrounds in a lightning storm, waiting and waiting. Kirk took off. He had somewhere to go. at like 7:30.
Wow.
And Rick was like, do you mind waiting? Because they might, you know, the storm might let up. So I'm sitting in this van, and he knew I had to drive through the night. And I'm like, okay.
You got it, buddy. Wow. A good soldier. Oh, wow. Marianne joining us from Kirk and Marianne each day on the program, 3 to 8 in the Boom Boom Room. She is evacuating, a mandatory evacuation from the Carolinas, making her way back up. I assume you're on 95 right now?
I don't even know where we are.
Oh, well.
I don't know what
drive lane north. This is.
I just listened to what the lady on the phone tells me. but let me tell you the one thing that the guy said that I thought was interesting. He said in the past, hurricanes always come in like from an angle or something.
Right.
And he said, this one is different because it's going to be head on, like completely straight for Kitty Hawk Duck, all the coast. And that's why he thinks it's going to be really, really bad for that area. And,
right.
And that's why he thinks all those houses are going to be wiped out.
Whoa. Yeah, normally they maybe, like, you know, shoot up the coast, like, you know, come up. This one, like she just said, like he
like
said.
Like a line drive right
straight,
to the face.
Headed straight towards that coast, so.
Damn, well, get home safe.
I better get my deposit back.
Yeah. Get the fam back. We'll see you when you're back in town. I assume we'll see you.
Apparently tomorrow I'll be on the air.
Oh, God. Well, they owe you vacation days, okay? Because this was not your choice to have to leave. So, Marianne, thank you for taking the time.
All right, thank you.
We'll see you when you're back in town. There she goes, Marianne. Kirk and Marianne, 3 to 8 in the Boom Boom Room.